So yesterday, Sayaji touched on the one of the noble works, Riyadana, seven kinds of the noble work. Yesterday, Sayaji explained seventh one, the Sutadana. So it needs to be explained some more further, but it may be too much. So Sayaji may go further explanation on the dana world, real world, other kind of real world. As mentioned repeatedly, Sutta is of two kinds, agama and adigama. Agama Sutta means learning. Adigama Sutta is the knowledge or empirical knowledge which is based on your own experience. And there are also literal meaning which need to be explained a little bit further, a little bit detail. And then after that, Sayaji would like to explain another kinds of the noble world, the Ganya Dana. So now Sayaji explain about the definition of agama. Its literal meaning is agama means the in terms of its root, agama means coming or the source of the bliss. So all kinds of bliss come from this type of sutta learning, knowledge. So that's why this type of sutta learning knowledge is called source of bliss, source of welfare, or the place where the our welfare coming. So especially what type of welfare or benefits come from this sutta? What are real welfare for us? Basically, our morality is our own welfare, our own bliss. So we have to restrain our physical, verbal behavior so that we cannot be harmful to ourselves or anybody else. Through the morality, moral precept, we can tame our physical and verbal behavior. These are our welfare. And another welfare is another bliss is the samadhi. We have to keep our mind away from mental defilements. So there are several kinds of mental defilements, as you know, the evil intention to kill, to steal, or to cheat other people, or to involve in sexual contact, misconduct. So these are all mental defilements. So we must reduce or subside these mental defilements through the power of the concentration. So this is also a type of bliss. At least we need to overcome mental defilements which can lead us to the woeful life, woeful rebirth. So in this way we can overcome three stages of mental defilements through the three correspondence virtues like Sila, Samadhi, and Panya, wisdom. And thus we cannot be no longer bounded to the samsara, the cycle, or the suffering. So we must practice until we reach a satisfactory state. Then only can we possess the Riyadana, the noble work, or the Sutta. So such type of Sutta is called another one, the Anugamika Osa, Anugamika work. So Anugamika means the work which is followed wherever we go. It's just like the seed of our seed or our shadow. So wherever we go, our shadow follow us. So in the same way, these sila, samadhi, and abhyanga we developed follow all the time to us wherever we go, wherever we are reborn. So nobody take it away. Nobody take this type of noble wealth away from us. That's why this noble wealth is also called another name, by another name, Ajiya wealth. Ajiya means undefeatable wealth. The wealth nobody can take away from us. So such type of noble wealth is called Ajiya wealth, Ajiya dana. So to obtain these blissful wealth, we need to learn how to practice correctly. The knowledge of correct practice is very important. That's why this knowledge is called Agama Sutta, the source of the virtues. Every kind of the virtues come from this source of the sutta. So that's the definition of the Agama Sutta. So Agama Sutta means it's defined in Pali, Agacchanti Itta Itinadi Agamo. The meaning is that any kinds of blissful things come from this source. That's why this source is called the Agama. So Agama, which refer to the learning, the knowledge you gain from learning how to practice. So we must try our best to attain the Agama Sutta and the knowledge we can attain from the learning. Especially we need to know how to defeat, how to overcome mental defilements. So we need to learn the correct method, how to overcome mental defilements, how to overcome the transgressive form of the mental defilements, how to protect our mind away from mental defilements, and how to cure mental defilements, how to defeat. So first of all, we need to learn the knowledge. We need to learn how to overcome mental defilements. We have to listen to the Dhamma talk. Sometimes we need to discuss with the teacher, or sometimes we need to read suitable books, and so on. So in this way, we can overcome the ignorance of correct method. We learn how to practice correctly. So by overcoming the transgressive form of the mental defilements, so that is we don't commit any kinds of evil deeds, killing, stealing, etc. Then we can escape from the several kinds of dangers, such as the Adda Nivada Bhaya, the guilty conscience, the being a regret. So if we avoid the committing evil deed, then we don't need to be regret. We can overcome the guilty conscience, Adda Nivada Bhaya, and so on. In this way, we can enjoy many kinds of the benefits from avoiding mental defilements or transgressive form of the mental defilements. If possible, we need to share our knowledge, our practice with others, so that other people also can get benefit from the practice, from the knowledge. They also can overcome transgressive form of the mental defilements. And so oneself and others, everybody else, can tame our mental, physical, and verbal behavior. So in this way, we can protect ourselves and others from several kinds of danger. So we need to have the moral shame and the moral fear, and we must be ashamed of committing evil deeds. We must be afraid of committing evil deeds. In this way, we can purify our mental, physical, and verbal behavior. First of all, we can enjoy the benefits of our moral conduct. That's called adatta, the own benefit. So if we can protect other people from danger through the metta, loving kindness, and karuna, compassion, so environment also become peaceful. If we have metta, we are always patient with anybody in any condition. If we have karuna, compassion, we are always helpful and kind to other, care about other people. And as we have metta and loving kindness, we have no hatred in our heart. As we had compassion, so we have no cruelty in our heart. That's first of all, once ourselves is become peaceful, and then other people also peaceful and safe, secure. So at least we need to keep the empathy or sympathy with others. We need to put ourselves other people's shoes. We should cultivate such a mental attitude through the metta and karuna, loving kindness and compassion. Thus we can easily avoid evil deeds. In this way we can protect ourselves, and spontaneously we can take care of others. So through the sila sikha, the morality, we can overcome the transgressive form of the mental defilements. We take a makilesa. But regarding priyotana kilesa, the active form of the mental defilements, we cannot take precepts to overcome transgressive or active form of mental defilements through the sila. So it is a sati mindfulness to subdue the active form of the mental defilements. There are other ways to overcome this active form of the mental defilements. Sometimes we can apply the reasoning power called patisankhana bala. But sometimes patisankhana bala, reasoning power, is not strong enough to defeat active form or the mental defilements. So the best way is, of course, the mindfulness. It's very simple, just to note when the kilesa come into existence. As mentioned repeatedly, all you need to do is to note whatever is occurring to you with the full faith and energy. So in this way, we can protect our minds from mental defilements. We can prevent kilesa from arising. So just like the curing the disease, the prevention is of course better than cure. So we have to prevent mental defilements from taking place, from arising. But if they take place, we have to cure that disease of mental defilements. We have to note it as it is. If your concentration is strong enough to face with such an active form of mental defilements, we can easily overcome the mental defilements. We can defeat the evil thoughts. Thought of stealing, the intention to steal other people, intention to kill, or intention to get involved in sexual misconduct, and so on. It's just like epidemic, the disease,
we must prevent the epidemic from infecting us in advance before too late. So in the same way, the best thing we should do is to prevent major defilements from coming in. So we must note all the time so that we can prevent major defilements coming in. So when there is a low major defilements in active form in our mind, then first of all, we are the first one to be peaceful, calm, and secure, safe. And as a result, other people around us also peaceful and calm and safe. So just imagine how blissful if we can prevent mental defilements coming in. So we can protect ourselves from danger, and spontaneously we can take care of other people's welfare. So that's the benefit of the development of concentration. Through that concentration, we can prevent mental defilements from taking place. In this way, we can enjoy all benefits, and we can help other people too. So it is a bhavana bala, the power you can generate from vipassana practice. So bhavana bala, the power of the development or the inside knowledge, is much more powerful than the reasoning power, the patisankhana bala. So Sero here explained the definition of bhavana. Bhavana literally means impari uparana. It's giving rise to a particular mental state. So bhavana means give rise to a certain mental state or wholesome mental state. So you have to increase such a wholesome mental state from, you have to make from small to big, from little to multiply. So you have to multiply the such wholesome mental state. So that's the definition of the bhavana. So the, as mentioned earlier, is protection and cure, both are important through the bhavana bala, the power of the insight knowledge. So the bhavana bala is one of the important factors of the bhavana bala is viriya, the effort, courageous effort. There is also called adabha. Adabha means the bhane energy. Through this bhane energy, we have to burn up the mental defilements. So we have to make great effort, courageous energy, without caring about our life and limb. We have to note, mindful, every moment, every second, that whatever object is occurring to us. In this way, we can open the road to liberation. So if we can note every moment, every minute, every second, the 5 minutes is 1 minute is 60 times, and then 5 minutes is 360 times, and so on. So in this way, we can develop the priya, wholesomeness, from small to big. So the more energetically we practice, the less active mental defilements become. That's the bhavana bala, the power we can develop by practicing sivatana
meditation.
So if you arouse the, such a courageous effort in practice, you are honored as a real yogi, real practitioner. So yogi is defined in the Pali text
the bhavanaya sutta pyogataya yogi. So whoever make great effort to the three kinds of the stages of the courageous effort, making this courageous effort to escape from the gravity or the mental defilements, is honored as yogi, the practitioner. So to boost up our energy, to arouse the insight, knowledge and wisdom, as a yogi we need to make great effort in the practice, so that we can be honored as a yogi, the practitioner. And the monk, if you are the monk, then you are monk yogi. If you are lay people, if you make great effort in the practice, you are lay yogi, you are real yogi. So by practicing Satipatthana meditation, you can prevent our mind from mental defilements, and we can escape the gravity or the mental defilements. When our concentration gets strong and mature, we can experience the true characteristics of the mind and the body, they are causality. Thus our inside knowledge becomes mature and mature until we attain Megaphala enlightenment. So before that enlightenment state, so we have to try our best to keep our mind away from mental defilements, especially Aramana Lucia Kilesa, the mental defilements which can lie dormant in the objects which we miss. So by overcoming, by defeating, by subduing mental defilements, which is lying dormant in the sense objects, we fail to know. In this way, become less and less. So in this way, we can overcome dormant form of the mental defilement too. So if we obtain the first level of enlightenment, Sotapatti Magga, we are definitely overcome, we can get rid of three forms of the mental defilements once and for all. That's the Sakaya Deity, the wrong view of the ego, the illusory sense of ego and self, and Vichikesa, skeptical doubt, and then the Silapata Paramata, the wrong view which is connected with the light and ritual. So these three major defilements can lead us to committing evil deeds, can lead us to the woeful lives and woeful rebirth. In this way, we have to defeat mental defilements bit by bit, stage by stage, and step by step, through the vipassana insight. That's called Panya Sekha, the wisdom training. So this wisdom training is connected with our knowledge, our learning, our knowledge of how to practice the correct method. So this learning or knowledge is beneficial to ourselves, and if we can share with our knowledge with others, other people also can benefit from our knowledge and learning. It's just like eating tasty, delicious food. When we have delicious food, that's here, we think of the one we love. So it's a naturally good food remind us of the one we love. So in the same way, when we have benefit from the practice, we remember people we love, so we share our knowledge, how to practice meditation. They also practice, and they also can overcome mental defilements to some extent. They can overcome the evil thoughts, evil intention, such as to kill, to steal, or to engage in sexual misconduct, or in cheating and so on. So in this way, our own war become peaceful. Spontaneously, we can protect other people war from dangers, and then we can help them to become peaceful. So countless benefits we can gain from the practice. So these kinds of the benefits come from the our knowledge. They are based on our knowledge, our learning, knowledge of the how to practice correct method. So our learning or knowledge is called Agama Sutta. Agama, the source of the bliss, source of the welfare. So second sutta, the knowledge is called Adhigama Sutta, the empirical knowledge. So based on the knowledge you learn or you listen, you practice. And then you, especially you practice Vipassana meditation until you attain what's attainable, or that is mega phala enlightenment. So the learning, the knowledge, this knowledge is connected with your own enlightenment, attainment or the enlightenment. So that's why this knowledge is called Adhigama Sutta, the achievement, spiritual achievement. So through the sila, as mentioned repeatedly, we can overcome the transgressive form or the mental defilement through the concentration active form, through the panya wisdom with the dormant form. So when we attain mega phala enlightenment, we can overcome mental defilements in dormant form. So in this way we arouse, we develop the empirical knowledge which is attained by practice in Vipassana meditation. That's called the Adhigama Sutta, the Sutta of the knowledge which we can attain through the mega phala enlightenment. So in this way the there are two kinds of the sutta knowledge, the intellectual knowledge or learning knowledge, and the Agama Sutta, and then empirical knowledge, Adhigama Sutta, which is based on your own experience or on the enlightenment. So through the Agama Sutta, the learning, we practice meditation, and we can overcome three, four of the mental defilements, three stages of the mental defilements. Especially we can overcome the mental defilements which can lead us to the woeful life. As mentioned earlier, the sila, through the sila, morality, we can overcome the transgressive form or the mental defilements. And through the samadhi, concentration, we can overcome active form. Through the vipassana panya, vipassana insight, we can overcome mental defilements, which is possible if we fail to note an object, which lying dormant in the sense objects, we fail to note. And through the mega phala enlightenment, we can overcome the dormant form of the mental defilements, which is follow us light after light, sandana lucia. So in this way, we can overcome all kinds of mental defilements based on our two kinds of the knowledge, the intellectual knowledge and empirical knowledge. So these two kinds of knowledge are, that's why I'm called wealth, noble wealth. Through these noble wealth, we can attain the banya wisdom, which is called banya wisdom, banya dana, the noble wealth of wisdom. So, Sarah, hope you understand the meaning of this process, the process. So now our time is up. Sarah, we continue this topic tomorrow. That's all for today. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. sadhu sadhu sadhu